You can use any of the strategies that we've talked or whatever you feel most comfortable with to figure out what or how many squares will fill this rectangle. This big rectangle that we have, how many squares will fill this big rectangle? Okay, go ahead and try to find out how many squares will fill the big rectangle. Okay, I heard someone say there might not be enough tiles. So do you have a strategy that you can use with the number of tiles? I want everyone to think. There might not be enough tiles to fill the entire space. But as mathematicians, you can definitely come up with different strategies to figure out how many you'll need. If you have figured out how many squares will fill this rectangle, go ahead and write down how many squares do you think will fill this rectangle. Go ahead and write it down. Okay, who would like to share how many squares were able to fill this rectangle completely? They were able to cover the space completely. How many rectangles? Emmanuel? 42. 42? Okay. Does anyone have a different answer than 42? Okay, so we all, Andrea, you have a different answer? Okay. You had 48? Okay. And I'll come back to you. Let me ask Emmanuel, how did you figure out that you'll need 42 squares or 42 tiles to fill this rectangle?
I counted the height and then the top.
So you counted the height? And how many tiles did you use for the height?
Six.
Okay, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's correct. 6 for height and?
7 for the top.
Okay, 7 for the top. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I could have easily moved it down. And in this way, it would be my base. And it even works well when you do it from the top. So we have 7 on the top. And then what did you do?
I turned 6 times 7.
So you multiplied 6 times 7. And your answer was?
42.
42 tiles. What is 42 tiles really telling you, Emmanuel? So the area of this rectangle is 42 tiles, okay? Okay. And remember, sometimes we use A, which means area. So if I'm writing A equals 6 times 7, which really means area equals 6 times 7 equals 42 tiles, okay? Raimundo. Going by the shape T? Okay, let me try that. How many of you use this strategy that Emundo is talking about? He said another way you could have done it is going by the shape T. How many of you use this strategy? Hey, Marquis, I see you, and Klein used it as well. Raimundo, so what? How many did you count on the top?
7.
And how many for this?
6.
So 7 times 6, 42. You got the same answer. Did anyone use a different strategy that they would like to share?
I just counted how many were there.
Okay. So, tell me again, what did you do?
I just counted the ones that don't have any tiles.
So you used all the tiles that you had first, and then you counted the blank spaces? Okay, that could be a good way, especially if you're trying to estimate, okay? Any other ideas? Okay, so how many squares will fill this rectangle? Let's go ahead, if you have not already written. Oh, that brings me back to Andrea. Andrea, how did you get 48?
I think I'm going to make squares and then
I counted by four, because we need four in America.
So, did you arrange it the way it's arranged right now? Did you do it this way? And then what did you do?
I counted by four going down.
From here? So you're thinking, okay, this is my four, and this is my four. Is that what you're trying to do? Is that what you tried to do? Okay, so you counted 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24. Then what did you do?
I counted the other side by 3.
And you counted the other side by 3s? Mm-hmm. So... By?
By
2s. Oh, this side. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Okay, so I know on this side I got 12. I had 24 on this side. Then what did you do? So 24 plus 12. Here's my 24. I'm going to add 12 to it. I get 36. How did you get 48? Do you think you're missing something here? At least one whole row? What about this one that you had in there? You counted on both the sides, but did you count these ones? Probably not. So if I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and add 6 more to the 36 that I have here, 36 plus 6 will give me 42, okay? So this can definitely be a strategy as long as we are adding it correctly, okay? All right, so how many squares will fill this rectangle? And now we know that 42 squares will fill this rectangle. How do you know? Who would help me write down this? How should I word this? What can I say? How do I know that it's going to be 42 squares? Who wants to help? Maritza?
Ms. Henry, I found out 42 squares fill up this rectangle because 7 times 6 is 42.
Okay, so and 7 is what?
7 is base.
So I found out that base equals 7 tiles and height is equal to 6 tiles. I multiplied 6 times 7, which is equal to 42 tiles. This is the area of this rectangle. Okay, remember, it's completely covering up the space of this rectangle. It's covering up the shape on the inside. It's the area that you're trying to find. Okay, let's move on to the third page. Do you see that now they've provided you with a measure for the unit that you have? This square tile that you have really is a square inch. The measure is square inch, which really means this. If I see this tile here, and you can draw one if you want to, and there's one drawn on the top as well. If you see this, it really means it's 1 inch in height and 1 inch for the base. So the area of this tile would be 1 square inch. Okay, and that is exactly what is given to you on the top. Now find out how much or what is the area of this big rectangle that you have, and I would like you to write down, how do you know? Okay, go ahead, figure out the area of the big rectangle and write down, how do you know? Go ahead, write down how many tiles will completely fill this rectangle, or how much is the area of this rectangle? You can definitely use the formula if you want. I also want you to write, how do you know? So go ahead and write, how do you know that the area is whatever you wrote down is the area for this rectangle? How did you figure it out? Try to explain it. Who would like to share with the class what is the area of this rectangle? What did you find out the area of this rectangle is equal to? How much is the area of this rectangle? Tatiana? 42. 42 what? Remember, we have to use the correct units as well. Now that you know what are the units for area, we will try and use the correct units. So if you haven't added correct units to your answer, please do. So let's try that again. Tatiana, what would be the area of this rectangle? 42 square inches. Does everyone agree with Tatiana? Does anyone have a different answer? Okay. Does everyone agree? Yes? Okay, so I can probably go ahead and write area equals 42 square inches. Or I can go ahead and write area equals 42 inches squared. Okay, whatever way works best for you. Okay. Who would like to explain, how do you know that that is the area? Let's ask Tatiana first. What strategy did you use, Tatiana? How did you figure out the area? You counted the base and then you counted the height and you multiplied them together. So your base was, base can be written as B, and it was equal to how much? 7 what? Is that square inches here? You're only counting one side. It's like pretty much like finding the perimeter, right? So we are adding 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch, 4 inch, 5 inches, 6 inches, 7 inches, right? So the base was 7 inches, okay? And then you said you've counted the height, okay? And height, h, was equal to how much? Was equal to 6 inches. And you used the formula to figure out, and the formula was multiplying, so area equals base times height, or area equals 7 inches times 6 inches equals 42 square inches. Hey, how many of you feel comfortable doing this now? Thumbs up, thumbs down. Let's see. How are we feeling about finding the area of a shape, especially a rectangle? Okay, I see a lot of you are ready. Let's do this. Before we look at some questions that you might see on the STAR test or on your benchmark for, just to get a feel of what your questions about area will look like on the test, let's go ahead and put our tiles back in the box. Okay. All the tiles back in the box, please. Thank you.